Hi, welcome to this video. Today I'm going to be painting this pug. I did a lot of these commissions. Most of them were for Christmas presents or gifts, but lately I've just been painting a lot of animals. I love painting dogs. These are some of the supplies I'm using. I love these Grumbacher paints. A lot of opacity in them. I use these primarily. These are the colors I use for some of the pet portraits. Golden Acrylic is a really good brand. Liquitex Basics, Winsor Newton. With these basics, they're great for background colors. I don't use them too much for the actual portrait. Some Posca pens, some Zig pens. I don't use those too much anymore, or the colored pencils, but they do help. There's no rules in painting portraits. There's no rules in art. You just do it. I was showing you a brush earlier. I use cheaper brushes because I don't really take care of them, and they're fine for what I do. Right now I'm just getting in some of the undertones, some of the basic shapes, making it look like a dog. I actually drew this before I started painting. I paint it red. This red is, it creates a nice little undertone, especially if there's skin tones in it. The way the acrylic just kind of bleeds through it, it gives it a nice tone. Refining it here, getting a little more detailed, layers upon layers. Great thing about acrylic paints is if you mess up, you just redo it. It's no big deal. As Bob Ross said, happy accidents, right? So yeah, you just have fun with it. Let it go. It's a nice stress reliever. Yeah, not everybody's going to be the best painter in the world because, you know, it takes years and years and years to really get good at something. What do they say, 10,000 hours? Something like that. But, you know, if you just try to start out painting, just get a canvas, get some paints, get a brush, some water. It's easy. You just do it. So what if you don't look great? At least you're doing it. You're not hurting anybody. Here I'm just getting in a little more detail. Getting some finer hairs. Short-haired dogs are actually kind of fun for me to paint. I'd rather paint a short-haired dog than a long curly-haired dog. Curly hair is kind of difficult. A little more detail work. And at a certain point, you gotta say, yeah, I think I'm done. And then after you're done, you take pictures of it, you look at it, and it's gone. And you're like, oh my God, I should have did that. I forgot to do that. Or I forgot to do this. This is actually my first painting of 2021. And I signed my paintings with the year. So, 21. And there it is. Thanks a lot for watching. I appreciate this. If you like this kind of content, hopefully you'll click that like button and share it and maybe subscribe. That'd be great. I plan on putting out more painting videos, more art vlogs.